Hello children, I am Kamal Kumar Thakur. Today I am going to teach you trigonometry of class 10 standard. You know, trigonometry, just you will face first time in this class. So first of all, we should understand what is trigonometry. You know, trigonometry is the word taken from the Greek word trigon, which means triangle, and metron, which means measure. Means trigonometry is the word taken from the Greek word trigon and metron. Trigon means triangle, and metron, it means measure. So especially concept of this part given by Greek mathematician Hipparchus given the concept in 3rd century BC. So especially in trigonometry, we study about the triangles, where mostly this is related to right triangles. You know, this part we use to find the length of the sides of the triangle by using their angles. So importantly, there are 6 ratios by which we will find the sides of the length of the sides of the triangle. The ratios are sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. In short, we take for sine sin, we use for cosine, we use cos, for tangent we use tan, for cosecant we use cosec, for secant we use sec, and for cotangent we take cot. So how these 6 ratios are relating with the angles of the right triangle and their corresponding sides? So let us see. This is right triangle ABC. I suppose this angle is theta. This is right angle at B, and we know that the side opposite of the right angle is hypotenuse. And rest of the adjacent sides are according to this angle. This angle is based on this side BC. So according to this acute angle, this we will suppose base. And another one will be the perpendicular. P. Now, how are they relating with these ratios? So, I have one trick to remember, because this is you are facing first time, so it is difficult, sometimes the children confuse. So I have one trick to remember this. We know that how you will remember Pandit Bhola Prasad Hari Hari Bol. Pandit Bhola Prasad Hari Hari Bol Sona Chandi Tol. So this is just for remembering. This is the trick just for remembering. Okay, this is not about any purpose, but just about for the learning. So here we will remember this word only, P, here H and here S, here B, again H and C, here P, again B and here T. So this S shows sin theta, this C for cos theta and this T for tan theta. And means sin theta means P by H. P by H. So this will be P by H. This cos theta means B by H. So easily comes B by H. And this tan theta equal to P by B. P by B. So this is very easy to remember. That's why we use this trick. Many tricks are there you can use. If you have another trick to remember, you know, then you can remember. But this is easy way to learn. In the beginning, you will not confuse when you remember this trick. So now, sin theta equal to P by H, cos theta equal to B by H, tan theta equal to P by B. Now, rest three ratios, cosec, sec and cot. So you should know, cosec theta is the reciprocal of sin theta. This is the reciprocal of sin theta is cosec theta. Reciprocal of cos theta is sec theta. Reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta. So if it is reciprocal, means cosec theta equal to, then will be sin theta equal to P by H, so cosec theta equal to what will be? Reciprocal means H by P. This will be H by P. Cos theta, the reciprocal of cos theta is sec theta. So sec theta equal to cos theta equal to B by H, so its reciprocal will be H by B. Tan theta, reciprocal of tan theta is cot theta, so cot theta equal to B by P. So these are the six ratios. You can see this sin theta, sin and theta, you know what is theta? I told you theta is acute angle. theta is the angle, and you know this sin and this theta, they are not the sin theta is the not product of sin and theta. Sin theta is not a product of sin and theta. This is not a product of sin and theta. Sin theta is the single word, single thing. It is relating about the angle, and this sin theta shows me with which side of the right triangle this is relating. So that's why sin theta is not the product of sin and theta. So it means sin is the not a coefficient of theta, and theta is not a coefficient of sin. Means sin theta is single word. Next, let's see the examples. If sin theta equal to 4/5, then find other ratios. How can we find other trigonometric ratios? Sin theta equal to 4/5, it is given. So how can we find the other trigonometric ratios? So I told, we have already studied the six ratios. Sin theta equal to P by H, cos theta equal to B by H, and tan theta equal to P by B. So for finding this, first of all we have to draw a right triangle. And we can suppose this triangle ABC. So we write, let ABC be a right triangle. Let ABC be a right triangle. Right angled at B. So sin theta is there. So this theta you can suppose anywhere. There are, in a right triangle, there are two acute angles. So you can suppose this theta anywhere. I suppose this theta here. So I told, according to this acute angle, this will be base and this will be perpendicular, and hypotenuse is fixed because hypotenuse means the opposite of right angle. So this is base, this is perpendicular, and this is hypotenuse. Since sin theta equal to 4/5 equal to, we know sin theta equal to, we know that P by H. So what is P? P is AB. And what is H? H is AC. So this 4/5, you know 4/5 is the ratio. Ratio means the two units, when they are comparing by division, and if they are in the simplest form, that is called ratio. So it is in ratio. So we need to suppose it's a value, let AB equal to 4x and AC equal to 5x. In triangle ABC, angle B equal to 90 degree. Therefore AC square equal to
AB square plus BC square.
You know, AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. This is the concept of Pythagoras theorem.
So we applied here Pythagoras theorem.
We have already studied in earlier class. What is Pythagoras theorem? Pythagoras theorem means in a right triangle, the square of hypotenuse will be equal to the sum of the square of other two sides. So that is the concept of Pythagoras theorem. So we applied here, so you can use here by Pythagoras theorem. AC, we have 5x square. AB is 4x square. BC we don't have, so we have to find BC. B square 25x square equal to 16x square plus B square. 25x square minus 16x square, we transferred this 16x square left side, so it becomes negative minus 16x square equal to B square. 9x square under root B. This square we transferred, so when you transfer the square, then it changes into square root. So this will be 3x equal to B. Means B is 3x. Now the other trigonometric ratios, for finding the trigonometric ratios, we need to know all the value of three sides. So these two sides values were already we had. Now we found the value of base. So other trigonometric ratios are sin theta is already there, cos theta equal to b by h. What is b? B is bc and the h is ac. So BC is 3x and AC is 5x. XX gone, so this is 3 by 5. Tan theta equal to P by B. P is AB by BC. AB is 4x, BC is 3x, then 4 by 3, you can cut this. Next, cosec theta equal to h by p, h is AC and P is AB, AC, value of H is, AC is here 5, we have supposed AC 5x by AB is 4x, 5 by 4, sec theta H by B, H AC by BC, AC is 5x by 3x, 5 by 3. Cot theta B by P, B is BC, P is AB. BC is 3x, BC is 3x, AB is 4x, so this will be 3 by 4. So the main purpose, I told you, by trigonometric ratios we will find, we will see the relation between the angles and sides of the triangle. So now I am giving you some questions for finding if tan theta equal to five by seven, then find other key ratios. If cos A equal to 2/3, then find other e ratios. Okay, so you can see I have given you two questions, just solve, and more examples we will give you in next